So, before we start, before I actually change a little bit my inventory and add my own and stuff like that, I will first like to integrate the inventory framework, just because I'm going to change so much stuff, I don't really want to be adding a lot more. So, the inventory framework, you can find it from my site, go to GitHub, inventory framework, and download all of it. Okay, so when you download all of it, I first have to download it as well. So I'll be back in a second. So from the inventory framework, here's what we're going to need. First of all, of course, we're not going to need the art. We're going to need the inventory framework itself. I think for this, we don't need the items. We should be fine. And of course, we don't need the scene. Or actually, let's add the scene because we're going to need the UI. Unless we have it as a prefab. Oh, okay, we have it as a prefab. So I'm just going to add only the inventory framework to this. And thankfully, we're going to have the UI canvas as well. Of course, that's going to load. And let's open this. And okay, I do have my inventory just fine as it is over here. Of course, it's going to get an error because there is no resource manager to this. But basically, I would like to just use... Actually, I think it's because it doesn't have any items. That's why this was happening. So if I set this to zero, hit clear, and hit play. And all the items that we have as starting items onto our profile. Let's see. Slot types, resources. And actually, yeah, we need these, the starting items. We are going to remove all of them. So let's go and delete those things. And we don't need any need either for the resource manager. So starting items, starting wearing IDs, no need. IDs, current IDs, I think we also don't need this either. Let's see, no, okay, we're going to keep this because we're going to need the instance IDs. Okay, so I'm just going to delete those two, and I do believe on the from the init, okay, the init is using an event to run this. So create starting items, we don't want any of them, just actually, let's find where we are calling this. Okay, it's through an event. So I'm just going to delete it entirely and be done with it. Awesome. So that, minimize. Let it compile. I'm going to hit play. Okay, awesome. So that is our scene. Let's go back into our battle scene. And then I'm just going to drag and drop my new scene, and I'm going to work with the UI into this scene. Of course, we don't really care about the lighting onto this scene. So we can just select this and say clear back data. And I don't know if we have to set up any changes to this. Everything is empty, so okay, whatever. Unless we have something over here, anyway. So, back to battle scene, and this will be our canvas scene. For example, let's say, okay, so that we're not finished with in 4 minutes. Let's create a few things. We already have an event system because I believe with this, actually no, I don't. Let's take a look on my scripts, on the inventory scripts. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I thought I had the scriptable object library as well in here, but we don't, so that's even better because we can start and adding it or create it or use that one again. And this will be just for the inventory framework. Awesome. So let's rename the inventory frameworks scene to UI. And I'm going to rename this to an entirely just UI canvas. Then I'm going to create an empty game object and I'm going to say inventory. Inventory holder, inventory manager. And we can add all of them underneath it. The event system can stay over here. And the manager hook will just run this on awake. Okay, I'm not going to position this right now. I'm just going to create a button. Actually, yeah, this needs a few changes. Anyway, I'm going to close this. And you know what? Since we are also here, let's also import the scriptable library just so that we have the events and we can start doing things from there right away. Let me go to my GitHub scriptable object library. Okay, GitHub scriptable object library. Download. So, opening this up, we have our scriptables folder. We're going to use all of this. Our variables might have some name conflicts, but it's okay, we can delete them. So, just going to use to drop the scriptables. And yeah, okay, that should work. Let's see, it compiles and we have any issues. We don't. So, here's the thing. On my scriptables variables, I'm just going to delete the transform variable because we already have one and we don't want another. And we also have a float variable to this. It has a few extra methods, but to tell you the truth, I usually never even use them, so whatever. So I'm going to delete that as well. Okay, so with all of this in place, here's what I'm going to go and do. Let's see where this error is. Oh, because it's a number-to-number comparison. Oh, damn it. Yeah, I shouldn't have done that actually. Float variable, so let me import it back again. And okay, just drop it there. But what I'm going to do, so I don't have to create my float variables again, I'm just going to remove them from the create asset menu. Okay, and because this is under the scriptable object, just going to remove this. And because it's under the scriptable object library namespace, and the other float variable we have, it's under the SA namespace, it's not really going to be an issue. Let it compile then. And here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to just add a button right now, just to show you how we're going to be able to use the events. So this will be crowds. And let's make it at yeah, okay, a toggle. Let's just make this run. I'm going to, of course, fix all of this later, not right now. Crowds run. Now, I'm going to go into my data and I'm going to create a new variable. This time it's going to be it's going to be an integer variable which is going to call stance. The stance by itself it's not really going to be doing anything. And on crowds, I'm going to click add and I'm going to say stance integer variable set and set it to 1. On running, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to say stance integer variable and set it to 2. Okay, similarly, we can have for prone, but because we don't have prone, I'm not going to do it right now. And I'm going to also say Let's say normal. Underneath this, I'm going to set normal to 0, of course. And I'm going to create an event. To do an event, I'm going to create a new folder, which I'm going to call events. And I'm going to create another folder, which is just going to be the game events. And in here, I'm going to create the game event, our first game event, which is going to be the set stance. Okay, then for set stance, for all three of these, I'm just going to add them. And I'm going to go and say set stance game event dot raise and save it. On my grid manager then, I'm going to add an empty game object underneath it, which I'm just going to call event or just events. I'm going to add the game event listener and I'm going to add the set stance over here. Then we can select, I think with the decision manager we can do it from here. Close all of this. And we're going to say that on, we're going to add a region, we're going to say UI event or just events, I guess, will do, and region. And first of all, I'm going to say public void set stance for current player. I think I might actually do, yeah, I think I'll do a dedicated script for this, but let's do it like this for now and we're going to clean it up later. First of all, I need the integer variable, which is going to be our stance int. Then I'm going to do a switch with our stance int dot value. Okay, and that one is going to have K0, break, 1, 2, and you can also, of course, add 3. So, with this in place, we're going to be going through the turn index. Yeah, we don't save the local one anyway. Okay, turn index player holder, not player holder. Yeah, okay, state manager, current character, set, in this case reset stance because it's the normal one. Two will be crouched, one will be crouched, two will be running, this will be prone, but we don't have this. So just comment it out. So set run, set crouch. Actually, we do have prone, but it doesn't do anything. So whatever, let's leave it like that. Set prone, okay. So we have all of this in place, set crouch, set run, set prone, and reset stance. But here's what I want to do. If you hit set crouch and you're already crouched, so I'm going to say if is crouched already, then just reset the stance. Okay, otherwise reset stance and set it to is crouched equals true. So if you're pressing the same button again, it's basically going to reset your state. So similarly, is prone, and delete this. Is prone and let's see, is running. Okay, just like that. So store that, save it, and under the on the grid manager, but yeah, as I said, we're going to create a dedicated script that's going to handle those events and those managers. I don't want to do a lot of things on the season manager because there's no need to. So I'm going to add the stamps, and on the events, for now, just going to go over here and I'm going to take the grid manager and I'm going to do season manager set stamps for current player. Okay, and because we're doing this as well, we can go over here and when we are setting the crowds, we can say play animation idle crowds. Similarly, over here we can just say play idle. Okay, and on the prone, same thing. Well, I guess we don't have for this, but we can just play idle over here. Set run is running, set stance play idle. And in both of these cases, it's going to play the idle because you might press the run from the prone position. Okay, or maybe we can have some different logic for that, but we'll see. Okay, so yeah, that's pretty much it. Let's go and test it. Let's say first. And even though the UI is on a different scene than the battle scene, it's because we are using the game events to use all of this. And let me change this to normal. So hit play. We don't have a character, damn it. So we should fix that. Season manager. Character is null. Return. Don't do anything. We're going to be having it disabled, actually, instead of is null. I think it's going to be better. This might change again. I'd like to first create the UI and then find which I like the most. Okay, so crowds. Yeah, normal doesn't do anything because it doesn't reset it. Run, however, works fine. And if we press crowds again, it works fine. Run. Crowds run crowds. Let's see why the normal isn't working. I believe the set to zero, yeah, because the set to zero is only doing a reset stance. So let's do the same thing and say play animation idle. So okay, this basically this video was how to integrate the scriptable object library, of course it's just drag and drop, and how to also integrate the inventory framework. With the inventory framework we get a lot of things. For example, we also get the with it, if you haven't seen the videos and you are curious about it, if we create a new folder for items, for example, and we can create weapon and cloth items. So not only we have a framework that will allow us to put weapons onto our player hands, both hands, we can also assign cloth items and so on and so on. So we can, okay, we can have a lot of things to fix and to add. So all that are going to come later. As always, you know what to do, like, subscribe, and if you like to see more stuff like this, of course, consider supporting me on Patreon so we can keep making all of these nice things. I'll see you next time.